Time to meet then today's brand new Julian's person. Now, we have many Julian's people who have interesting stories joining us on the programme, but not many of them have written and published their life story. I have the book here. Oh, well, that's exactly what my next guest and Julian's person today, Martin Montague from Hampshire, has done, joining me in the studio. It's lovely to see you, Martin. Thanks for coming in. Now, we've got the book in front of us here at the reservation. Beautiful hard copy. Quite an interesting front cover. Explain that for me.
Yeah, basically it's a railway tunnel because as I was growing up, as kids, we used to graffiti in a railway tunnel in Hilsey.
Okay.
So it's pretty representative of that when we used to go down and tag on the walls and stuff.
Which we're saying is a very bad thing, obviously. You shouldn't be doing that. But it represents really your youth. And this is, I don't know, would you describe it as your rags to riches story, perhaps?
Yeah, definitely. It's a kind of coming of age on a council estate. It's quite gritty. But there's some really interesting characters in there. And some very interesting things that actually happened to us as we grew up.
So tell me more then about your childhood growing up on that council estate.
Yeah, it was interesting as much as it was tough, but it was kind of normal. You just got used to it. We had times when things were really difficult, but it was really character building, and it gave me a lot of lessons through life that have helped me immensely.
And this was in Portsmouth where you grew up?
Yeah, initially Lee Park and then Purbrook near Waterlooville.
Okay, and it is fair to say you've turned your life around.
Absolutely.
Just explain what you do now.
I own a dot-com company, a light manufacturing business, a surfwear company.
So it's fair to say you are extremely successful in the business world.
I wouldn't say extremely, but I'm semi-finalist Entrepreneur of the Year.
See, I would say that's quite successful.
Yeah, I've done a few things.
How did you turn it all around then?
Basically, I was just always really driven to try and make something in my life. I just wanted to escape the reservation. That's why the book's called The Reservation. Mm-hmm. And initially, I went into a factory job. And I decided that I didn't want to do that for the rest of my life. It was too tough. And then I got a job selling cars. It was really funny. Some of the bits for that are in the book. And then into a estate agency, then finance, and then self-employed with an internet company.
And at what age did you go self-employed then?
Wasn't till about 27, 28.
So you must have been incredibly driven, though, to go through those jobs, and they're tough jobs as well. I mean, you know, car salesmen and estate agents have enough bad publicity.
That's right, yeah.
without me even commenting on it. But to go from that and then launch your own companies and be, as I've said, very successful, because you're quite modest about it, how were you driven enough to do that?
I just always wanted more for myself. But it's not just the money. I just wanted to do something that would make a difference. I own a patent, or we own a patent rather than a company. I invented a rear brake light for push bikes a few years ago that runs on an accelerometer, because I knew that most of the accidents were happening at junctions.
Yeah.
And I just came up with the idea one day. But initially, I made my money through ringtones. And I was lying in the bath one day thinking, what can I sell that costs no money? And the phone rang, and I looked on Google, results 3, and I thought, ringtones, going to sell ringtones. And I think I was the first ever company in the UK to advertise ringtones on the TV.
Oh, my goodness me. And then from there, and what's your sort of daily life like now then? Are you working all the hours, or are you able to just take a step back now?
I work 2 or 3 days a week in the office.
Can we just swap lives? Would that be possible?
Yeah, it's a nice life. I'm not going to lie. You know, it's nice when you can go out and buy a new Lamborghini or Ferrari or something else like that.
Yeah, we definitely need to swap lives. So the book then, why did you decide to write it?
Because it's all the untold stories of people on council estates, essentially. Those looking to escape the place. And some really interesting and very, very funny things happen. The backdrop was in the early 90s. It had all the rave years behind it, and we were all off doing all sorts of weird and wonderful things. But I just felt it needed to be written.
And what was that process like? Was it cathartic? Was it quite sad in a way?
Yeah, I mean, sometimes I'd be there tapping on the keyboard and I would be crying with laughter. Other times I'd be really sad. It was a real emotional roller coaster. But I broke my leg last year, and that helped me finish the book because I was sat on the sofa for a long time.
Right, okay. And the process to get it published, what was that like?
Yeah, that was fine. I dealt with a company called Splendid Media, and they're a really good publisher. And Steve and the team there have been nothing but great, because as a kid, I was actually dyslexic. So although I could get the words down, and every word in that book is my own, none of that's been ghostwritten. The actual spelling and grammar was just terrible.
But somebody sorted that out for you.
Yeah, that's right.
I've just opened it on the page. You've got some lovely photos in here as well. Is this is all from you growing up, I presume?
That's right, yeah.
Look at that. What did the family make of this?
Yeah, I think they were shocked by a few bits in there, but, you know, on the whole, they're pretty excited about it. And yesterday, it was actually, it came out yesterday. It's on the Amazon bestsellers list.
Is
for
it
two
really?
Categories. Yeah.
Amazing. And it's just, I've got this in hardback. Is it available in paperback as well?
It's hardback and Kindle at the moment.
Hardback and Kindle.
And at
okay.
the moment, the Kindle version's free on
Amazon.
Is
it? Oh,
for
okay.
a couple of days.
Oh, there we go. That's been a bit of an incentive. We're talking about happiness on the programme today, and it's interesting you've come in. How would you define happiness?
I'd just really say that happiness is about making sure that you and the people around you are really happy and content.
Yeah. And it's not all the money in the world.
No, although it does help. Makes life a bit easier, I will say that.
As you get into your Lamborghini, I'm sure it does make a difference.
Yeah.
Really, really good to meet you, Martin. Thank you so much. And the book, The Reservation, out now. Thank you.
BBC Radio Solent.